Indonesia, Brazil, Spain. When seen from above, the landscapes of these three countries look beautiful. Green, lush, somehow pleasing to the eye. But if you look closer, you start to understand why it's so satisfying to look at. In all three landscapes, there is an element that repeats, a pattern. Palm trees in Indonesia, these green mountains in Brazil, the perfectly straight lines of red and ochre in Spain. Monocultures, deforestation, overgrazed land. Reading the landscapes of your home country is very important, because if you understand what might be going on with the environment, you will also be better able to protect it. And it's just a matter of practice. Everyone can do it. One of my very first trips to capture Ecosia's planting efforts was in Indonesia. I was awed by the beautiful sea of green below us as we flew to our planting partners in Borneo. It wasn't until I learned more about the palm oil industry that I realized that this pleasing image actually hides a horrible truth. 80% of that green scenery were palm oil-producing palm trees, substituting former primary rainforest, the only home of the orangutan. Here's a lesson I learned. Tree monocultures on any landscape, like these olive trees in Spain, indicate that something might be wrong. See, nature needs diversity to thrive. In any given ecosystem, every tree, every plant, every animal plays a very specific role. If a whole landscape is filled with just one tree species, this means that animals that used to live there have been pushed away. All the food they needed to survive was swiped off to plant just that one tree species. And what's more, tree monocultures also affect the health of the soil. A healthy soil also needs a diverse set of trees and plants. Soil is very important. If we lose soil, if it becomes dried out by the sun and unfertile, we lose the very ecosystem that sustains life on Earth. Where do we grow food? If you look around you in the countryside, do you see bare soil? Everywhere we were in Spain, we saw red, ochre, and brown earth. As Fran and Miguel told me, two of the founding members of Alvelal, Ecosia's tree planting partner in Spain, if you look around the countryside and see bare soil, that's really bad. In industrial agriculture, farmers are pressured to produce as much quantities as possible of whatever crops they harvest. To produce as much as possible, this is how traditional farming works. Farmers will clear their land of any tree and grass and create neat, tight rows to plant their crops in. And even if they are not currently growing anything on it, because it's not the right season, they will still make sure their lands are cleared so they don't have to do all the work in the next season again. The problem with this? We saw it all over Spain. Millions of hectares of earth standing in the sun, being dried out in the summer or frozen in the winter. This makes soil lose all its moisture, all its life, eventually becoming infertile. So look around you, go to the countryside. Are there rows and rows of cleared land, at most covered with a thin layer of green grass? Now let's go to Brazil. Just like in Spain, we drove for hours and hours through rows of mountains. And one thing I noticed in both places, apart from those monocultures, there were really no trees, especially not on the mountain slopes. Turns out, the lack of trees on mountain slopes is one huge red flag. Bare mountains are a problem. Without trees on our mountains, there are no roots to absorb the excess water when it rains. The earth quickly becomes muddy and washes off. And it does so at high speed, dragging fertile soil with it along the way and often flooding entire towns. It ruins farmers' arable land and, in the worst case, like on palm oil plantations, It will also wash the chemicals of pesticides along with it, flushing them right into rivers that hold drinking water. So, get out of the city and look around at the mountains. Are there trees on the slopes? Reading a landscape correctly is important, because if you understand what's going on, you can hold local and national authorities accountable to do something about it. It's fascinating how much we can understand nature and connect back to it by just looking around us. The more you understand about how nature works, the better you can protect the climate.
Hi, I'm Fatima, and I document Ecosia's tree planting projects in Latin America, Spain, and Southeast Asia. Ecosia is a search engine that plants trees. Ecosia works like any other search engine, but we use our money to plant trees all over the world. If you'd like to see more of our videos, make sure to subscribe to Ecosia's YouTube channel. For more background info on this episode, make sure to read the description of this video. We'll link to useful resources on the topic. And download Ecosia to help us plant more trees. Thank you.